There's no combination of words I could put on the back of a postcard. No song that I could sing, but I can try for your heart. Our dreams, and they are made out of real things, like a shoebox of photographs with sepia tone loving. Love is the answer, at least for most of the questions of my heart, like why are we here and where do we go, and knock on us so hard. It's not always easy, and sometimes life can be deceiving. I'll tell you one thing, it's always better when we're together. It's always better when we're together. Yeah, we'll look at them stars when we're together. Well, it's always better when we're together. Yeah, it's always better when we're together.
She's hiding in that room right now because I've got the dresses up.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. That's okay. How are you?
Good.
And all of these moments just might find their way into my dreams tonight. But I know that they'll be gone when the morning light sings or brings new things. For tomorrow night you see that they'll be gone too. Too many things I have to do. But if all of these dreams might find their way into my day-to-day scene, I'd be under the impression I was somewhere in between. With only two, just me and you, not so many things we got to do or places we got to be. We'll sit beneath the mango tree now. Yeah, it's always better when we're together. We're somewhere in between together. Well, it's always better when we're together.
Thank you.
say it best when you say nothing at all. All day long I can hear people talking out loud. But when you drown out the crowd. Oh, Mr. Webster could never define what's being said between your heart and mine. The smile on your face lets me know that you need me.
Feel like I've had long enough with you.
our friend the Wind. Jimmy and Jake, the day we have all waited for has finally arrived. We welcome the families, the friends, and everybody wishing them happiness. We've had the pleasure of watching their story become a reality. Jimmy, you were told what would happen if you messed with a miner. And Jake, you knew the delightful bunch of Scrabble tiles that you placed on that board would lead you to this spot. You have had both experienced life, love, and you have wonderful children to show for it. To truly love, to give yourselves to one another, to commit completely to a marriage takes courage and strength. You both have this courage and strength. You see that life does indeed go on. You began as friends, and you will soon be husband and wife. Always remember, a good friend will bail you out of jail, but a great husband or a wonderful wife will be sitting next to you saying, "Dang, that was fun." Now you stand before us with a hope for a better future, with faith that you will prevail in this marriage, and with your commitment to make this union one for the ages. We are here as witnesses to the promises that you make to each other today. Also, remember this promise, that if life gives you lemons, add tequila and salt and invite us all over for the party. Marriage should not be entered into lightly. I've spoken to both of you, and I understand that you've thought deeply and seriously about your obligations and responsibilities in this marriage. This marriage will stand not just by the authority of the state, not by the seal on the certificate, but this marriage will stand on your commitment to each other. You are making this commitment to love one another, even in frustration, to remain faithful, even in temptation, to always be loyal, even when everything seems against you, and to listen to one another, even if you would rather not, or one of you goes over the deep end. Always remember, you have two ears and one mouth. One of you might just say, "I didn't say it was your fault. I said I'm blaming you." So let us listen twice as much as we speak, so there's no misunderstandings to what the other is saying. A puzzle box can be turned over, and the pieces are all unassembled. You've taken each other's unassembled life and put it together again. Now that you have chosen to be together, remember, you don't stop laughing because you grow old. You grow old because you stop laughing. And any problems that you have faced alone have now been divided in two. You now have a caring partner who will help you with any of the solutions. Family isn't always made up of just flesh and blood. It is made up of those our soul chooses. It is those we keep near because our soul feels more confident in their presence. Families flourish when there is trust that the one's well-being will be cared for as if it's their own. This marriage is a union of not only two lives, but of two families melding together in one caring, loving family unit. Brendan, Chandler, Macy, you'll now light this candle to signify and symbolize the unity of the family. Take us for a minute. I gotta light this candle. The writer and preacher Frederick Buechner says, they say they will love, comfort, honor each other till the end of their days. They say they will cherish each other and be faithful to each other always. They say they would do these things not just when they feel like it, but for better or for worse, for richer or for poor, in sickness and in health, even when they don't feel like it. In other words, the vows they make can hardly be more extravagant. They give away their freedom. They take upon themselves each other's burdens. They bind their lives together. The question is, what do they get in return? They get each other in return. There will always be the other to talk to listen to. There is still someone to get through the night with, to wake up the new day beside. They both still have their lives apart as well as a life together. They both still have their separate ways to find. But a marriage made in heaven between a man and a woman can become more richly together themselves together than the chances of either of them could have managed to become alone. Now we'll have a reading by from Corinthians by Madison. Maddie?
Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. But where there are prophecies, they will cease. Where there are tongues, they will be stilled. Where there is knowledge, it will pass away. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part. But when completeness comes, what is in part disappears. When I was a child, I talked like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I put the ways of childhood behind me. For now we see only a reflection as in a mirror, then we shall see face to face. Now I know in part, then I shall know fully, even as I am fully known. And now these three remain, faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love.
And the greatest of these is love. Jake, your vows, please.
As I stand here with you, I can't help but look back to where I began. That first date, our connection was immediate. You can't describe a feeling like that. It's the kind of thing you let flow, and you go where it takes you, and here we are today. I'm excited to embark on this journey with you. I have never felt such balance and support. You are my rock. You are my sounding board. I strive to be a better person because of you. Such confidence in me. I know that together we can take on anything that life throws at us. There are many things on our course, and today I make a series of promises to you. I promise to keep a light heart and a sense of humor. I promise to be patient, although that's going to be kind of tough because you're chronically late. But you did great today.
The most honest vows I've ever heard.
I promise that I will be honest. I will respect you. I will support you. But most of all, I promise to trust you, and love you, and cherish you. I feel truly blessed because you, I all the love that transcends and grows. It gets better with time. You've opened your heart to my daughter, and you love her as your own, and that completes my heart. I couldn't ask for more than you've already given me. I get to laugh with you. I get to cry with you, care for you, and share with you. I get to walk with you by my side and build a life with you. I take you to be my partner for life and give you my hand and heart as I bind my heart, my soul, and my life to you.
The night we met, it was a comfort in your presence. There was a warmth in your voice and certainty of intent as we shared our thoughts and revealed our most prized possessions. Everything of importance to each of us then has proven to be our common ground today. For me, Brendan and Shane have always been my rays of sunshine. And the reason for pushing on and doing good in this world. For you, Macy is the center of your universe and your purpose. As I learned more about who you are, I fell in love with you. Not only because of the man that you are with me, but because of the father that you are, the son that you are, the friend that you are. You're what's good in this world. You're patient and you're kind. You've shown me every day what love looks like by modeling these virtues, not only to me, but to our children. I have never known a love to take the bad and make it good quite like you do. When I'm at my worst and feeling impatient, you never tell me how to feel better, but instead you show me the light by modeling your patience. When hardships get the best of me, and I'm coming undone, you hand and sign. You never tell me how to pull it together. Rather, but you take my hand and you help me do so. With a healing science, silence, and assurance that says, I got you. Thank you for making life's burden seem lighter, and for making me smile and laugh out loud every day. Because of your steadiness, no matter what the day brings, I look forward to falling into your arms at the end of it. So finally, today, I get to tell you how happy I am to become your wife, and how honored I am to take your name, Jacob David Meyer. I vow to love you in sickness and in health. I vow to honor you as you have and continue to honor me and my children. I vow to respect our commitment to one another today and always. I promise to not take our time together for granted and to cherish your presence in my life, now and as we age. You make it easy to love you. You make me want to be a better person for you and our children. And even though I'm almost perfect the way that I am, I know that I am better with you.
I got the picture.
This might be. Can everybody hear me still? Okay, good. Jake, do you take Jamie to be your lawfully wedded wife? Jamie, do you take Jake to be your lawfully wedded husband? We now come to a beautiful and extraordinary part of the ceremony, the ring exchange. Your rings are a gift from each of you to the other. The rings you are about to place on one another's fingers are symbols. They are symbols to remind you of the vows you have just spoken, and of the everlasting love bound in your hearts. Jake, please place this ring on Jamie's finger and repeat after me. With this ring, I be wed. Jamie, you take this ring and put it on Jake's finger and repeat after me. With this ring, I be wed. And now, by the power vested in me in American Marriage Ministries and the state of Michigan, I pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss each other to seal the commitment. Proceed to the River Raisin Room for hors d'oeuvres and drinks. Family, you know who you are. Stay around here for a few pictures. We'll be all together soon. May you all go in peace.
I'll break, let it come down, cry.
Watch me when you call my name. You see me sparkle, see me flame. Sing a song, play a game. Oh, I'm so glad you came. Watch me when you look my way. You feel me smiling. Be my night and day. Touch me in your own sweet way. Feel me tremble. You take my words away.